To Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay, and we've got another one from our fantastic Jens Lichko. As usual, I'm not sure if I've got the name right. Fingers crossed, there you go, thumbs up anyway. But fingers crossed I have got it right. Get on with it, Tel. We've got one from, I believe this, the brewers here, I believe the kind of head brewers or the people in charge, maybe Dutch, I'm not sure, but we've got a Belgian brewery, but it's the actual name, De Dure Brewers, is I believe Dutch for the Mad Brewers. Woohoo! So yeah, I like a bit of mad brewing. All proper brewing, all proper lovely proper brewing, and that, you know, no messing about. This is dry hopped, so if you've got one of these, don't keep it kind of cellared and things, because the whole idea of it being dry hopped is that it's, you know, it's going to be nice and punchy. You can keep it for a little while, which I've done a little tiny while on it, you know, it's, you can keep it for a certain amount of time and the hop's still going to be punching in it. If you're going to keep it for like months or even years, it's not going to happen. Right, so let's crack it away and pour it in my little Belgian glass. There we go, this is lovely. Let's get cracking. We all right? Oh, we're lively. Quite a plain crown. Quite a white plain crown. So nothing to see. But that's all good. Put that down. Getting a bit fizzy up the top there. Sorry, I ain't even showed you the bottle. Look. It's Arabia. Dry hopped with nugget, I believe. And it's quite lively. So I'm going to pour it quickly, if I can. But carefully, hopefully. This is non-pasteurized, it's not messed about with, not kind of filtered and everything else. The bottle condition, I can't see any yeast going on. Maybe the smeariest of smears, but you know what? I'll pour that in after. Let's show it as it is there. Look at that, isn't it lovely? You know, beautiful. Look, can you see the carbonation with me white shirt on it? Yeah, look. Nice carbonation going on, nice fluffy head, but kind of rich and puffy and cloudy, you know, that sort of lovely delicate but kind of, you know, just light and lacy. Now this is proper what they call lacing. Watch look, see, it looks like lace as it crumbs glass, but it's very very light and delicate. And I like that. I don't like a big quilty head. Oh, you're getting those lovely, kind of those lovely acids and oils that the lupulus, that the kind of hops and everything else bring out. And big nugget, that nuggety punch. They dry hop it with the actual hop flowers, little green hop bind the hop. Little green flowers. They look a little bit like pine cones, but green, if you've ever never seen hops. They kind of like look like a green pine cone, but tiny, like a small version. And they're actually a flower. And the ones that are used for brewing are the female ones, you know. Not sure why, but they're the ones that do the business. And get all the lovely flavours and oils. Mm. I think, funny enough, I think cannabis is the same. I think the females plants in cannabis are the ones that have the buds and everything else and all that. And cannabis is related to hops. So it's Cannabis lupulus something or other. Anyway, let's get on. Now, this is a Belgian beer. It's, what are we talking? What style? We're in the ABV of, what are we talking ABV? Doesn't say. Surely they've got an ABV on here. I think it was, if I remember rightly, it was about 8. Yeah, 8% ABV. So let's have a smell. Let's just see if I can twirl it. These sort of glasses are difficult to twirl in. But I'll have a little twirl. They smell slightly different in these sort of glasses. Only run it up to your thickest point on your glass. Whatever glass you're using, run it up to the fattest point because you get a larger surface area. And if you gathers in towards the top, the aperture on the top of this, the opening, is probably half the diameter or half the surface area of the actual drink. So you're getting it doubled up, you know, ratio of 2-1. So you just swirl it round, it gathers all them little smells and aromas in there. Carbon dioxide's slightly heavier than air. And then you stick your bugle in, get your lips up to the glass. Stick your whole face in, you know, and get a breath in as well as that. Now you're getting a little bit of kind of almond, you're getting a little bit of all them lovely pure malts and that, you know. You can almost taste on your tongue as you breathe in little tangerines and things and marmalade. Oh, that's so delicious. It really is. I'm almost drinking it on my tongue. It's coming in that rich. Oh, wow. That is lovely. It's a strange thing. It's not smashing me bugle with richness, or me nose, I should say. But it's kind of coming in there and dancing around in up me nose, you know, and then around the palate as you're breathing the both in and filling your head up. Fill your head up with it. And as you fill your head, as you feel that smell and taste beers, let your mind wander into different places and different points in your life. You'll kind of go, oh, marmalade, that reminds me of, you know, my nan cooking marmalade round there on whatever. Or it reminds me of this, or in the mornings when you get a bit of marmalade on the toast and put it back under and things like that. You get all lovely little tiny little memories that ain't kind of big firework memories. Sometimes they are. But it reminds you of just little things like mum making marmalade on toast in the morning, or staying at bed and breakfast and having marmalade on toast, things like that. Cheers, I'm going in. Cheers, everyone. Oh, wow. Oh, that's big. It's big. It's got that lovely, beautiful, dry-hopped kind of finish that you get. Oh, wow. It's a lovely bitterness there from a live, fruity, big, dirty, great kind of a whole hop flower. It's got that bitterness, but also it's got a sweet marmalade. Kind of a marmalade made with tangerines or something like that. Because there's that perky little character as well. That little perky, acidic sort of tangerine thing. That instead of a blood orange, more sort of splodgy. This is a ping, 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 yeah. You know, little fighting, punchy little sod. Oh, you've got a mixture of lovely malts in there too. And so these lovely, rich malts, a little bit of kind of different sugars. Like a Muscovado sugar or something like that, just perking around there, just sweetening things up. You got those lovely malty flavours, like crystal malt or something like that. A tiny bit of bitterness off of it tastes as if there's a bitterness coming off of a dark malt in there. But there's not, I wouldn't imagine there's a dark malt in there. I'm not sure, that would come off of something like a crystal or a caramel or something like that. Just kind of those sort of things going on. But that's it. That is lovely. It really is. Oh, blimey. One more, let's have a go. Oh, cheers, Jens. That is lovely. Prost, I should say. That is absolutely lovely. That really is. That's a beautiful beer. Now, what else can I say about this? The Mad Brewers been around. I think the brewery's been there on the site for about 200 years, I think. So it kind of, it's not a new brewery, but I think the kind of them might have been taken over by the dual brewers since. But it is extraordinary, absolutely lovely stuff. Pardon me, excuse me. It is quite fizzy, as a lot of beers seem to be, especially the hoppy beers. It seems that, and it's nice. I think it's a nice thing, but I have mixed feelings about it. That kind of carbonated sort of thing, that it leaves a carbonated flavour in the beer, but also it's burpy and blah, you know, which is fine. It perks flavours up as well. So it's, like I say, I've got mixed blessings on hefty carbonation, and it's still quite lively in there, even though it's in a wide open glass, which lets it go quicker. But that is really lovely. It's holding on to that head. Really lovely. Just one point, something that winds me up. When you get people swirly, twirly, twirly, and then they go, wallop, and put the glass down. You go, why did you twirl it? What are you twirling it for? Oh, that is really lovely. Right, one more thing. Right, in your mouth, in your nose. You can do that in the pub without people going, oh, what's he doing? You know. And then have a drink. So, full up, tip. So, ready? Little distant apricots in there as well as you drink it faster. Little distant apricots dancing around on the palate. Kind of almost dressed. Little apricots dressed in fissileless skin. You know, you get a little fissileless if you want to peel it. You know, little fissileless skin. Not the crispy stuff, but the little skin. You know, and imagine when ingesting that. It's just that slight bitterness that's not too attacking. I'm going to pour the bottom end in, which if there is any yeasty weasties in there, which I think there might be. Ah, good. And there are, look, you can see the more murkiness to it. Now, for me, that is a pretty, pretty thing when you get that. I really don't know what the sense of in people, oh, it's gone all cloudy, and you know, I don't know. We drink wheat beer, Clad, well, some of us do, you know. Some people prefer the crystal wheat beer. But have it with a bit of Clad in it, have it with a bit of yeast, because that yeast really brings the flavours. And it also perks the other flavours in, like the hops. Pardon me, really burpy. The hops, the malts, things like that. It kind of perks them up as well. And it also gives a lovely, richer mouthfeel. Look how that's swirling there. It's like, you know. So, let's go. Cheers. Mmm. Mm. Now, yeasting suddenly sweetens and smooths and everything. It suddenly gets a little bit as if it's kind of a little bit cooked, as if it's in a dessert. Those fruits are now in the dessert instead of raw, you know. That's glorious. That is really glorious. Lovely stuff. Right. If you see it, buy it. Dun, 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 dun. Buy it, try it, and like it. I know they've got that on in Beers of Europe. I'm not sure where Jens got it from. But thank you very much. Thank you very much, Jens. Thank you. I should say thank you, sir. That's what I should say. No, thank you very much, Jens. That is a glorious beer, and thanks for sending me that. He's got nothing to gain out of it. He's just kind of just sending beers to people just for the love of it, for the love of seeing people enjoying it, which, you know, that's really lovely. And, you know, it's... I just think that when people enjoy what I do or what we do or whatever, you know, enough to kind of send me something because they enjoy watching me drinking it. It's lovely, isn't it? Yeah, it's lovely. Yeah, and it's when people know what they're on about as well, and they go, I want to listen to Terry talk about it. That just is impressive to me. Right. Buy it. Try it. Bum, 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 bum. Love it. Beautiful stuff. Cheers. See you in the next one. Don't be late. With a man for a world with a new